Hello and welcome from Bavaria. This is the Everlast of the Green Horde, and I have now an artillery piece for Team Yankee for the Russians. It's the 2S1 Carnation. This is the English word, and the Russian word would be Gvozdika. Spelling errors are not counted today. So this little box contains three tanks, three self-propelled howitzers with 122mm guns and one unique card. So let's have a look at in this box and we will see in the close-up. So let's have the close look on the 2S1 Carnation battery. The box front cover shows us two artillery howitzers. So on the back side you can see the content. Three 2S1 and one unit cord. And there's the quick assembly guide. Yeah, you have the tracks, the hull and the turret and even the gun. And the assembled unit. So let's go inside this box. So you have also your plastic box for transportation, always a cool thingy. So let's look inside. First we have the unit cord of the 2S1. The 122mm howitzer cannot fire as far as the M109, but 88 inch is really, really long range. So you can have a long range artillery shootout, maybe. Counter battery fire, maybe. So the point costs are a little lesser than the US counterpart. It's costing 14 points for 6. And these are the special rules. Not so much special rules as the M109, because you don't have all these options for minelets, bomblets, and laser guided missile. Okay, Russia don't need this shit. Because we are ruling with carnal firepower. So what we have in the box, at least we have three hulls with turrets, the guns, and six tracks. So let's look at the hull, the tracks, and the gun in close view. So let's begin with the hull and the turret. What I can see is really sharp molded, like the M109. It's also as sharp as the M109. Additionally, you can see maybe. So let's focus the camera. Can you see here through? These are very thin parts on the main lights. These are very thin. A really good molded, a really good cast. It's amphibious. So really cool, really it's outstanding. Outstanding sharp model. Place for the magnet. So but the only drawback is you have lesser details. The details are sharp as the M109, but you have lesser details. It's the whole model looks a little boring. Maybe I will find later some backpacks or even some things to put on the hull here. But to me, it looks a little bit boring. The M109 is a wow model. This is a model users say okay, cool, nice, but not more. because you're missing the amount of details. So you have the tracks. The tracks are all indicated for left and right. Right one here, left one over there. Bam. Glue it on. The gun in here, and then smash the Americans. Yes. So the gun is not as the Americans' counterpart. You have to glue it in, and it can't be removed. So you have some fixed gun, not some removable option. But it doesn't bother. The gun is not as long as the Americans, but nonetheless deadly, I think. So, a really cool addition for the US forces. Not for the US map. It's for the Soviets. The good thing is, for a US player, the Soviets can only field one six 2S1 battery, and not more. Like in World War II, you had 12 firing guns at least, and this was really devastating for a German player. And now the amount of guns are reduced to a more mentionable space, but you have not only some gun firing artillery, you have also rocket artillery, and the rocket artillery is coming at the end of the March, I think. I don't have it now in mind, and yeah, I would say only say descendant of the Katyusha. So, nice little box, I hope. It's as fun to build as the M109. I hope you will have fun too with this box. And yeah, I will see you and this little thingy on the battlefield. So, have a nice weekend. And this is the Everlast. And have a nice day. Bye.